of Lagos is a testament to what multi-genre storytelling is. It branches out in so many sub-genres that you can't call it a chick flick. It's not a movie about love, it's an action movie like Spider-Girl. It's a horror movie. It's a workout tutorial like Skinny Girl in Transit. It's a comedy movie. It's a science fiction. It's an animation. It's a crime movie. It's a thriller. It's an adventure. It's a cartoon. It's a porn. It's a dance film. It's a soap opera. It's a comedy skit. It's a godai. It's a dance movie. Now, it's a documentary about weed smokers. Fire of Lagos is Nigeria's take on Insecure, from the music score to the almost opposite but similar characters. This girl is this guy. This guy is this girl. This guy is this guy. This girl is this girl. Then at the end of the show, this girl is now this girl. This girl is still this girl. This guy is now this guy. And this guy is Antonio Bandara.
I smell cap.
In Lara of Lagos, you follow a freelance photographer that is not married. And if I'm not wrong, Lara is in Nigeria, so you know the world is on her neck to get married, because that's a title every girl must possess before they can be known as humans. If you did not know, that was sarcasm. She's dating Chooks, a guy that in early episodes of the show, you have a feeling deep down in your soul that this guy is definitely beating this girl. Nobody can tell me wrong. Chooks does nothing in the earlier episodes but complain about how broke she is, and trust the show to always remind us how broke she also is. Pay 60k for facilities, her account says 1,500. She has a close friend called Tess. I like her just because of how she says the word.
Yo, bitch!
Tess is a character that wants to have the best things in life. She gets new cars, travels around the world, and reminds her friends at every point that they can do better, as long as an old man is sponsoring them. Making bad decisions is what Lara as a character flourishes in. This guy is probably a fraudster, and this guy right here has tendencies of beating you in the future. To be honest, there's no way you can make a bad decision. Oh my God. You made a bad decision. The issues with the show are the episodes are just so short, you get confused at the end. And yes, it's strategic, but man, it's short. Okay guys, let me watch episode 1 and give you my honest opinion. Let me just blink for a second. Okay, that was a refreshing... this is episode 12. Really? The music score in the show are so good, you can smell the copyright coming from a distance. Some of the video editings in the episodes flow very well, and some just felt odd, like this episode where you can hear the director shout cut. But this show is not just about sex. The heart of the show comes when you see a little bit of her in you, her struggles to make her dreams a reality, but being held back by her being broke. I really admire how believable these characters are. Nothing they do is out of place, and they don't force this higher value or higher meaning to the characters. My expectations are simple. After she confessed to him, this show switches from a chick flick to a domestic violence ad. Because I told you guys, this guy is definitely beating this girl.
How can I say this? I know I'm late to the party. I said I'll sip a Bacardi. Moving too fast like a Ferrari. She put the S in assassin. Okay, I'm breaking my zone.
Question of the day. Can you break dance? Because I can. I'm break dancing, but nobody can see it. Bye. Three. I'm recording, sir. D1, I am recording. They make noise in this house, and I will leave this house for everybody one day.
Demi.
Hello?
Demi.
Hello?
What is the problem with you? You are never at home. Tell me which music you are doing, Abeg. I have warned you several times about the kind of friends you are hanging out with. I've told you. It's your life.
It's your life.